Hello, my name is Sharif, and this is the fourth tutorial video in our series of development videos helping to explain how we build mobile workspaces for the Dynamics 365 for Operations mobile app. So where we last left off, we were in our sales order management workspace. We were viewing all of our sales orders, and we had just created an action that allowed us to create a new sales order. And on this action, we allowed a user to type in a customer account. So we're going to enhance this experience. We're going to turn this customer account field into a lookup, and I'm going to show you how to do that. So first, let's hop into the design experience for the sales order management workspace. I already have it selected here at the top. I'll click the edit button, and I'm going to go ahead and navigate to that action we created before. That action was on the all sales orders page. So I go ahead and edit that, go to the actions tab, select the action and edit it. Now, the way that you normally configure a lookup is you select the lookup field, you'll go to properties, and you'll see the properties for designing the lookup down here. But in this case, those properties aren't there because the way I designed this action was I actually typed in that field value rather than using a lookup that was provided in the product. So let's go ahead and resolve that issue. I'm going to go ahead and redesign this action by using the lookup rather than typing a value into that field. So I go back to my all sales orders form. There we go. So I'm going to redesign my action. Remember our design principles here when we're designing pages and actions. We want to open a top level form and we want to make sure we don't touch the form. We want to make sure we click select fields first. And then we go through the process of selecting the fields we want to display in the case of a page and or clicking the buttons and typing in the data that we want to make available to the user in the case of an action. So in this case, clicking the buttons means clicking the new button. And then entering the data means selecting the customer account from the lookup that appears. So we're going to select a customer account here. Going to stick with US001. Okay. So the field has now appeared. Go ahead and click the OK button. Make sure we get the dialog. Let's us know that the mobile app has correctly identified. We did create a record on sales table, which is the expected backing entity for my action and my all sales orders page. We'll go ahead and close this dialog. Now we can configure our lookup. And we'll see we have the ability to add a lookup page. So here we can select an existing page and then we'll be able to set these two fields and I'll explain what they are directly afterwards. But right now we don't have a lookup page. We don't have a page that shows a list of the customers, right? And the framework understands that. You notice in that list it didn't show me the pages that do have, which could show the list of all customers or show the list of all sales orders or show the list of the sales order details. Those pages aren't appearing here. This is only going to show pages that are applicable to this particular control. And that's because the framework understands the binding that is beneath this particular control. Let me go ahead and show you what the binding looks like. So for this particular control, we were on the, I think the name of the form is sales create order. That's correct. So let's go ahead and open up Visual Studio and take a look at what information is hiding behind this metadata. So here we are on sales create order, and this is the customer account field I typed that value into. We'll see that it's bound to sales table, right? And this is important. It's bound to cust account on sales table. Let's go ahead and look at sales table, look at cust account. So the framework, the mobile framework underneath the hood is inspecting this metadata. It's going through that field binding, and in this case, it's going down into an EDT to determine what relation this field has to another entity. So here we have an EDT for cust account. Let's go ahead and look at that guy, and we'll see the relation is defined here. Right. So the cust account is bound to is an EDT that establishes a relationship to the cust table account num. And here we go on cust table. This is the form we're going to end up using to create our lookup. We'll see that we have a grid here, and this grid is bound to cust table. So that's going to work great. That means that for the values for each row that appears in this grid, it's going to have an ID for cust table, which is going to allow our lookups to work. So we'll go ahead and minimize the form here. We'll go ahead and back out and create our page for all of the customers. All right, now we're going to open a top level form for all customers. All right, form is open. We're going to go ahead and select fields. The two fields we care about, the important one is going to be the account, right? Because this is the field that is going to be set on that lookup, right? The account, the customer account number, US-001 or whatever it may be. So let's go ahead and select the account field. We'll also select the name field because this will just be pleasant to look at inside of the lookup, give you some more context for who the account number refers to, All right, so those are the only two fields I want in my all customers page. I'm going to get a list with these two fields in it for each customer. Go and click done there. All right, so my page is now appearing. I can go back to my my action for creating that sales order, and now I can configure the lookup field. There we go. So go ahead and select all customers. And by default, the data field and the display field are set. So what these two fields mean, the data field is the field that's actually going to be set into the field when the data is passed to the server. So remember that action that we designed in the previous video. As a part of creating that action, the system was capturing three or four things. The first thing being the opening of the all sales orders form. The second thing being the clicking of the new button on the all sales orders form. The third thing is typing the account number, or rather selecting the customer account number from the lookup. And the fourth thing being pressing the OK button on that dialog. So in this case, that third step, the data value we want to go into that field is going to be the field we select here, which is going to be the account number. And the field to display is the field we could display inside of the lookup after the user selects a value. So for example, in another scenario, your data field may be something that isn't very user-friendly to look at, like a rec ID in some scenarios. So you would set the rec ID to the data field, but you wouldn't want to display the rec ID to the user after they've selected the value. So you could choose a more user-friendly field here. For example, I could change this to name, and then the customer name would appear inside of the field on the action in the mobile app after the user selected a value. But we'll save that for another time. I'll go ahead and leave this as account, so that we're going to match the same experience I would see on the form, where after I select the customer, it's just the customer account that appears in that field afterwards. Go ahead and click done there. I'll get back to my workspace and save my changes. There we go. So we've updated the metadata. Must remember to pull to refresh. And now let's hop into our lookup. Let's go ahead and open our create a new sales order action. And we see the lookup is now enabled. We have the drop-down button visible there beside the field. Pressing the drop-down button shows the list of customers as we expect, with the account number and the customer name. Selecting the customer, as we see, it sets the field. And what we see here is the display field, which we also chose to be the account number. That's what's displayed to the user. They can simply tap done now. And that new sales order is going to be created for customer US001, Contoso Retail San Diego.